In this tutorial, we are going to see what are loop statements in robot framework. So whenever you have n number of operations which are repetitive in nature and you want to over and again do the same action, either you need to repeat that statement over and again in the code or you can use loop statements. So for example, if I want to print n numbers like log 1, log 2, log 3, and let's say if I want to go till 100 numbers, one way is I simply write down this thing over and again. Other way is I use loop statements. So for loop syntax goes like this, where you need to use the keyword for, and before that you need to put a colon. And then as a second thing, you need to have a counter, which would be having the values between a range. Third thing, you need to have this in range keyword, and then two parameters you need to pass to it, which is the starting point and the ending point. So starting point is 1 and the ending point is 3. Next is we need to define the body of this for loop. Whatever comes in the body get repeated for those many number of times from starting point till ending point. Body always starts with a slash, and when you hit enter, it automatically comes in with a tab, right? So let's say we want to print the value of I. So I simply use log of I, and this is how my log I statement would get repeated from that starting point till that ending point. So from 1, 2, 3, this statement would get repeated, right? So one thing that we need to take care of is, if we see here the output is, I have defined the starting point is 1 and ending point as 3, but the output is 1 and 2 only and not 3. Now if I talk about the entire story of how this execution has happened, so when it comes to test case 1 TC1, it comes to the first statement, which is for loop, right? So here we have a counter variable I, and we have two values, starting value 1 and ending value 3, right? So initially I is initialized with starting value, which is 1. So here at this statement, I becomes 1. And before entering to the body, it also checks whether that counter value is less than the ending value or not. So since I is 1 and 1 is less than 3, it goes inside the body. So body says that we need to print the value of I. So therefore it printed 1. Once the body is executed completely, see, we have one statement here, but we can have multiple statements. So once that entire body is executed, the value of I is incremented by 1. So now the value of I becomes 2. It comes to the body again. Before it comes to the body, it checks the condition with the next value of I. So for next value of I, which is 2, it checks again whether that value is less than 3 or not. Yes, the condition is true, therefore it goes inside the body and it prints 2 there. Therefore again the value of I is incremented by 1 and it becomes 3. Now before executing the body again with the new value, it again checks the condition whether 3 is less than 3 or not. And the condition fails, therefore it does not execute that body again, and therefore it didn't print 3 here. So that is the logic why it printed 1 and 2. And if you want to see all 3 values, you need to have that value as 4. Therefore it would be going inside that condition for value 3 and it would print 1, 2 and 3. You can check here, if I make it 4 and if I run it again, now I see all 3 values, 1, 2 and 3, right? And similarly, if you want to run it for 10, if you want to print all 10 numbers, you need to have it from 1 to 11, and therefore it would be printing all 10 values. So that is the logic. Now this is one of the syntaxes of for loop. This is the older version of for loop syntax. There is another syntax which is for an end statement. Right, so here you need not put colon, you need not put any backslash for the body. You directly need to have this kind of structure where the for loop starts with for and it ends with end keyword, right? And rest everything is same, right? So it also produces same output. So the new versions of robot framework would be supporting that feature. For now, you can use any of these. Next is when we don't know how many times we want to repeat a loop, where let's say we have a list, let's say I create a list A with n number of values and I use the keyword create list to add values to that list. Let's say I add some values like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and let's say I don't know the count. It can be anything, right? And I want to have a loop which repeats for all the elements of the list. So what you need to do is, again, you need to use for, and you need to have a counter, let's say I. So variable I, and instead of using in range, I am using in, and I just need to pass on that list name. So it will automatically repeat for all the elements of the list. And I can print the value of that list at that particular index, or let's say I am simply printing the value of I, right? So that is how I can iterate through all the elements of the list. If I run it, I can see that I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? So that was the second thing. Generally in other programming languages, we call this loop as for each, where we iterate through all the elements or each element of the list, or you can say an array. Let us jump on to the next function, where we have exit for loop. We can exit the for loop at any point of time using this keyword. So let's say I put exit for loop here in the body itself. So when it enters the for loop, it prints that value of I for the first time, but then it encounters the second statement, which is exit for loop, and therefore it exits from that loop from that point only. It does not execute for any other value, right? So that is how we can exit. There is another keyword or another function where we can exit based on a condition. So that is exit for loop if. So if that condition passes, only then it will exit from that for loop, otherwise it won't be. So let's say I say that if I is greater than 3, only then exit, otherwise let the loop execute as usual, right? So you can see that initially it printed 1, 2, 3, and when it becomes 4, so it printed that value because log of I is before that exit statement, and then it checked the condition whether 4 is greater than 3 or not, and that condition passes and it exits from there, and it does not execute for the value 5 and 6, right? So that is how we can use these two keywords to exit out of the loop. Another important thing to note here is the nesting of for loops. So let's say if I have a for loop, like for I in range 1, 2, let's say 10, and I want to have another for loop inside that for loop. So if I use for, let's say I use another counter j, and let's say in range, in any other range, for example, let's say from 11 to 15 or 20, whatever you can put here, and then I define the body of this inner for loop, I do not get any another backslash here when I hit enter. Let's say I put the log statements, so log of I, and I try to run this kind of structure. Let's say instead of I only, I print I and j also, so that I can visualize those values. So now if I run this, you would see that it gives me an error that there is no keyword named as for. So this is coming for the inner for loop. When it comes to first for loop, it goes inside the body and it tries to execute the keyword inside that body. So the first keyword it encounters is for loop. Here Robot Framework was expecting a direct function or direct keyword which it can execute, but here it finds a loop statement and therefore it gives an error with that keyword name, right? So what can be done if you want to implement a inner for loop or a nesting of loops? So what you need to do is you need to create a user keyword. So for example, if I create a keyword named as F1 and I, let's say, put the same logic there, I just copy and paste that inner for loop here and I control with the argument. Let's say I pass the argument value I here, and while calling, I'll pass on that value like this, right? So this way I would be able to have that inner loop structure. So it comes to value of I and then it executes the inner loop for all the values. So when I is 1, it executes for 11, 12, 13, 14, and then value of I becomes 2, and therefore again it prints for 11, 12, 13 and 14, right? So I hope this is now clear to you how we can implement nesting of for loops. But yes, when you have multiple levels, if you want to go for 3 or 4 or 5 levels, it would really be very difficult in this kind of structure, right? So If you have any questions, feel free to write to me and we'll talk about more functions in our next video. Thank you.